here at my favorite place, the Pick and Pull. Looking for a 2009 Chevy Cobalt, and it's going to be a 5-speed. So it's meant to be in row 42. It's actually one of the cars I saw at the insurance auction, but wasn't able to come out and inspect it, so we might have to come back and get that the dash. Here it is. Oh yeah, I'm actually glad I didn't buy this car with the buckling there. I'm going to be pulling out the clutch, pedal, and assembly. And probably the shifter and linkage. Alright, let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is remove this nasty seat. That's pretty disgusting. All right, let's remove the seat, make it a little bit easier to get to that clutch pedal. Just 2 15-millimeter bolts. Definitely worth taking the time to remove the seat just to make this whole thing a little bit easier. So this was one of the cars that I was looking at buying when it was up at the insurance auction, but I'm glad I didn't. It's a smoker car, looks like they had pets, and the damage was definitely more than I thought it would be. And that's why you always want to inspect these cars before you buy them. And even though I do need parts, it's still cheaper to buy the parts individually than having this this car at the house. was pretty hard to film, but there are 4 10-millimeter bolts. So there are 4 10-millimeter bolts. Pull this off real quick. All right, to make this more accessible, I'm actually going to try to remove the pedal by itself. Which takes a 13 millimeter. Let's see if that helps give me a little access.